All right, this next one is going to be for the YouTube channel Ancient Mother. Her name is Loretta, and we're going to go with permission from her guides. Okay, we're asking your guides. Yes, we're doing it now, and yes, we know she's given permission. Yeah, it's the first maintained consciousness in her soul. Has she been there all her life? Yes. No walk-ins? No. Okay, she is not interchanged. No, you come out now and then, they said, if they need to communicate. Okay, so we got that. Now, her soul, nucleus of her soul, first maintained conscious life in her soul. First maintained conscious life in her soul. We're going to go to the nucleus. The very first lifetime is, oh, somebody's being funny. They said a tree. I said, no, that's not what I want. I want something that looks like it can do more than just react. Okay. All right. Let's do something like a person or an animal or whatever. You know, something that has less, more reactionary. All right, we're going to go with the first conscious lifetime in her soul. All right, now they're getting it. All right, first conscious lifetime in her soul is a girl. They're coming out with a girl, and the girl is, the nucleus was there, but that would have been, that would have been the tree. Yeah, okay, and so from that point on, she was out in the universe, and then she incarnated in the little girl. Okay, got it. Alright, so now we got the little girl. A little girl was in the, they're saying British Isles. I see you in a village. It's a very long time ago. You were there in this village that had a lot of people in it. It was, they're showing me something like in the movie Beauty and the Beast. The village, it kind of looked like that type of environment. You got to be older, a woman, and you had a family. So basically, your whole lifetime was there in this village. You had, they said that you died in childbirth. Did she die in childbirth? She was there for a long time, and she was sick, but they didn't see her actually dying. You were having a difficult time during something, but you didn't. You were just sick for a long time afterwards, is what they're saying. So it wasn't giving birth. It was just something that was going on around that time frame afterwards. You were there. I still say that you were there for a long time. But it's like after giving birth to this one child, you were just, you just got real sickly. And I do see you getting around and moving around, but other than that, you grew up, you just had a really healthy attitude, a really good life, a really good smile on your face. Everything was really good for you. Even your children, I mean, you adored your children. Okay, just want to make sure they haven't got off track. And you had a couple, but it seems like after this one lifetime, you just, not lifetime, but this one child, you just kind of, somebody said fell apart. It just drained you. It took you down. I don't really feel like it's just from giving birth. There was just something going on. I mean, I'd say, they said it could something be your hormones. I mean, there's a lot of things that they didn't know about things back then with women. But you just didn't want to have anything to do with your husband. I mean, you just withdrew is what I'm getting. You were still good with your children. You still did what you could to, have a life. But just melancholic and just really, you just feel like your energy was so low drained. And I don't feel it was anything like a spirit possession or, you know, an attachment of any kind. I just feel it was just the environment, the situation, like you were sad. Was her husband abusive? Because they did throw something like that. He was just unhappy. He was unhappy. So, yeah, I see he snaps a few times. And that made you even unhappier because you just didn't understand what was going on with your body. And I see now. Okay. So, yeah, it was basically what we would call cancer today. I'm sure they had some other name for it. And it just started ravaging your body. Yeah. So, like I said, it was after the baby was born, but you just started falling apart after that. So I don't think it was because of the childbirth in the sense of hormones, you know, maybe. But I think there was some other things that were going on around you at the same time. And that was one of them. That was one of the reasons why you were so drained and getting drawn, you know, drawn in from it. But anyway, other than that, up to that point, you seem like you had a fairly good, happy, good, lucky life and stuff. Anything else for Loretta? No? Okay. Hope you enjoyed it. Bye-bye.